So static hazards occur when a glitch appears in a signal, usually an output signal, whose value is supposed to be constant. Dynamic hazards, on the other hand, happen when the output of a specific combinational logic circuit is supposed to make a transition. And it does make the transition. However, we observe a glitch while making the transition. So a dynamic 1-to-0 hazard happens when a signal makes a transition from 1 to 0. But while making the transition from 1 to 0, it glitches back to 1 first before settling on 0. This is called a dynamic 1-to-0 hazard. A dynamic 0-to-1 hazard, obviously, is one that appears when we make a transition from 0 to 1. And again, the glitch appears by dropping back to 0 for a limited period of time before settling on the final value of 1. In this video, we are going to take a look at the anatomy of a dynamic hazard, because it is significantly more complicated than a static hazard. However, it is tightly related to it. So once we figure out the anatomy of the hazard, why it happens, we can figure out how to solve it. So a static hazard occurs when we have a single logic value that has multiple paths, at least 2 paths through a logic circuit, and then it reconvenes at an AND gate or an OR gate. The 2 paths have to have differential delay and have to have a logic inversion between them. A dynamic hazard, on the other hand, occurs when a logic value has more than 2 paths, at least 3 paths, through the circuit. So a dynamic hazard might occur if a specific logic variable has 3 paths through a logic circuit. In this case, you can see X, the variable X, has 3 paths through the logic circuit. The second condition for the dynamic hazard to occur is that there is a static hazard embedded within it. So if you observe these 2 gates, the OR gate and the inversion, these 2 gates actually are a static hazard. So this is a static hazard that we looked at in detail. This is a static 1 hazard. The value at this internal node is supposed to be 1, but because of the differential delay through the path of X and X bar, the value of X plus X bar temporarily drops down to 0, giving us a glitch. Now, this static hazard does not appear at the final output node of the circuit. It appears at an internal node. For a dynamic hazard to appear, there also has to be a 3rd path for the variable through the circuit. This 3rd path is the lowermost path in this diagram. And this path has to have a longer delay, specifically a longer combinational delay, than the path containing the static hazard, which is at the top here. In this case, the output node of the circuit, let's call it F, might observe a dynamic hazard. The reason is the lower path, which gives us XD, is going to try to dictate a transition on the output node F. And it will eventually manage to dictate this transition. However, because the upper path with X plus X bar observes a static hazard, this static hazard is gonna cause F to observe a hazard itself. But because F is not static, because F is making a transition, that hazard is now a dynamic hazard. This will become much clearer when we trace the signals through the diagram. Now, like static hazards, dynamic hazards are always triggered by a transition in one of the input signals. In this case, we have only X as an input signal because we are isolating a path that could have a dynamic hazard. And X is making a transition from 1 to 0. Because X is eventually going to feed an AND gate, that AND gate is going to observe the same transition as X. And so eventually, F is going to take the same value as X. Let's actually write F in terms of X as a logic function, because this is going to be very helpful. So this node is X plus X bar. And the lower node is X. Of course, we are writing a a logic expression, so delay has no role to play here. And if we follow the rules of simplification for Boolean logic, x plus x bar is equal to 1, and so f is supposed to be equal to x. So f is supposed to follow the transitions in x. So if x makes a transition from 1 to 0, f is supposed to make the same transition from 1 to 0, which it will, except that there will be a glitch in the middle. Why does this glitch appear? First, the node x plus x bar is going to have this form. We know for a fact that x plus x bar has to be equal to 1, but we also know that because of the differential delay between di and do, this node is going to observe a static 1 hazard. And so we see the static 1 hazard making an appearance here. The node xd is going to follow the same transition as x, but there is some kind of combinational delay here. This delay doesn't exist. The dynamic hazard is not going to appear. But if it exists, and it has to be longer than the delay in the upper path, then we run the risk of having a dynamic hazard. So this delay could be anything. It could be a bunch of combinational logic gates. It could be a series of inverters. It could be anything. Because as we will see, dynamic hazards do not necessarily appear because this particular form is present explicitly. It appears because this particular form can be implied from the circuit. In any case, xd is going to be equal to x, and it's going to make the same transition except after a delay of d, which is longer than the total delay that the upper path takes. In that case, f is going to be the ending of xd and x plus x bar. Now, because xd makes a transition down to 0, f is also going to make a transition down to 0 after xd makes a transition down to 0 with a delay of dA, which is the delay of the AND gate. On the other hand, within the one phase of the signal xd, we do observe a static hazard on the node x plus x bar. Because f is the output of an AND gate, this dip down to 0 will make it out of f. And therefore, we will observe a dynamic 1 to 0 hazard. Notice that the internal node observes a static hazard. However, at the output node, what we observe is a dynamic hazard. It's important to understand that dynamic hazards occur because of an embedded static hazard. So this form is the form that we always observe or can reduce a circuit to when we have a dynamic 1 to 0 hazard. When we have a dynamic 0 to 1 hazard, this is the form that we observe. You can see that it is basically the complement of the form on the left, meaning that we have an AND gate first and then an OR gate. And we can actually derive the same kind of logic of why the hazard occurs, because in this case, f is going to be equal to x dot x bar plus x. Now, because x times x bar is always equal to 0, then f is going to be equal to x. Now, if we trace the transitions that happen through the circuit, again, any hazard is going to be triggered by transition in an input signal. In this case, the input signal is x, and it makes a transition from 0 to 1. This internal node is going to suffer from a static 0 hazard, and it's going to appear as a glitch up to 1. The node xd is going to copy the form of x because it's just a delayed version of x, and that delay has to be greater than the delay of the upper path. Now, because f is actually equal to x, then eventually f is going to copy the transition that x made. So this transition you should observe eventually making it to the output. However, because it's an OR gate as well, there's a period of time when both xd and xx bar are equal to 0, and this is that period of time, which appears as a glitch. So this is a 0 to 1 dynamic hazard. Now, in both cases, when we're talking about 1 to 0 or 0 to 1 hazards, if the delay of the lower path is actually lower than the delay of the upper path, then we will not observe dynamic hazards, because in that case, the transition in the node xd is going to mask any hazard that we see at the node XX bar. So like imagine if XD occurred earlier, like at this point, for example. So if XD rolls up at this point, then it doesn't really matter that we have a glitch here, because XD is going to mask it, and we are going to observe F rising up to 1 and settling at 1. We'll not observe a hazard in this case. The same applies also for a 1 to 0 dynamic hazard. So just because you have a structure that looks like this doesn't mean that you have to observe a dynamic hazard. You also have to have a specific set of circumstances that relate to the differential path in the circuits. Now, this also applied to static hazards, because in static hazards, if we didn't have a longer delay for the inverted path, X bar, than for the true path, or if the inertial delay of the final gate, DA, blocked the glitch, we wouldn't actually observe a glitch at the output node. So what we are doing here is we are detecting the possibility of a glitch appearing, of a hazard appearing. We are not actually affirming that it will occur. It's important to notice that the logic structures, the logic equations that correspond to these two equations are x into x plus x bar and xx bar plus x. In both cases, these expressions should simplify to x, which we know because the output node is supposed to copy the transition in the input node. However, it doesn't, and we see a glitch appearing, and you can actually see from the logic expression itself why the glitch appears. The glitch appears because this bracket, in this case, represents a static hazard, and this product, in this case, represents a static hazard. Now, this static hazard, in both cases, these static hazards are supposed to be masked by the variable x making a transition. However, these are not x, these are x delayed. And if this delay is long, then x could actually be zero while this glitch is happening, allowing this glitch to seep to the output. And this could be one while this glitch is happening, allowing this glitch to appear at the output. This is exactly what we saw happening when we did the tracing through the circuit diagrams.